This is 2022 MacBook Air powered by a new M2 Apple Silicon. By default, it comes with 256GB of SSD storage and 8GB of RAM, which I think it's pretty skimpy, even though they claim that M2 is such an optimized chip. You have to pay extra for more speed and space, as always. This MacBook Air actually belongs to my sister, but she let me have it for a few days so I can make another MacBook reviewing videos. I made sure she's getting 512GB of SSD instead of getting an extra RAM this time, and you should too. I'll be comparing M2 MacBook Air with my M1 Max MacBook Pro. Keep in mind that M1 Max MacBook Pro was 2-3 times more expensive, although it was from earlier this year. Press the return key. First, go to App Store and download this BlackMagic Disk Speed Test. This app will run a series of tests writing and reading data from your SSD. Compared to M1 Max MacBook Pro, M2 MacBook Air showed half the speed, but it is twice as fast as the M2 256GB model. Controversially, M1 MacBook Pro was faster than M2 MacBook Air in terms of disk speed if you have 256GB. M2 MacBook Air showed 2.5 to 2.8GB per second, and M1 Max showed 5.5 to 5.8GB per second. This M2 MacBook Air showed a right amount of read and write speed. M1 Max was just faster. I usually add more RAM first because you can always get more external SSD for a fraction of the cost, but make sure you get the at least 512 this time, because disk speed actually matters every second when you're just watching TV with it. I'm returning to my old test. I'll do a rendering of 3D animation using Blender. Previously, M1 Max shows 5-fold improvement over Intel MacBook Pro. Let's see how M2 MacBook Air performs. Here, I am loading a motion track 3D streamlines over Tesla Model 3. I'm constantly failing it using M2 MacBook Air. After several attempts, it turns out that to be a memory problem. This frame from a 4K video took more than 10GB of RAM, so this MacBook Air, which has only 8GB of RAM, could not proceed with it. Here's a quick comparison, just rendering a single image. M1 Max MacBook Pro takes about 10 seconds, while M2 MacBook Air takes 15 seconds. Both are using a metal GPU acceleration. M2 was slower by 25 to 50%. Next, I'm combining 4.5 minutes of 4K videos using QuickTime. Compared to my mighty M1 Max, M2 showed 50% of the performance, but M2 MacBook Air didn't give up with Will of Death while loading all the video at once, so this is promising. M2 MacBook Air took about 3 minutes and 37 seconds, that's 1.8 times slower compared to M1 Max, which took only 2 minutes. Last time, M1 Max showed 470% improvement over Intel MacBook Pro, so M2 is still 2.6 times faster than 2017 MacBook Pro. I'm now using DaVinci Resolve 18 to export 9 minutes long 4K videos. Although M2 MacBook Air is not intended for this type of professional use like video editing, it's just tempting to edit 4K videos on your lap. M2 MacBook Air took about 8 minutes and 12 seconds, resulting only 52% of the speed compared to M1 Max, which took only 4 minutes and 15 seconds. Last time, M1 Max showed 25% improvement over Intel CPU, so M2 renders 65% as fast compared to 2017 MacBook Pro. DaVinci Resolve runs natively using Apple Silicon, but based on last two tests in two separate occasions, QuickTime is better optimized for M1 or M2 chips. While doing all this rendering, there's no fan sound and it didn't heat up at all. So overall, I'm just happy to say that my M1 Max MacBook Pro is superior to my sister's M2 MacBook Air. But this is by far the best looking laptop since this MacBook Pro that lit up. The midnight black finish resembles F-117 Nighthawk stealth aircraft, and this is much lighter than MacBook Pro. Some performance thresholds are expected because MacBook Air doesn't come with cooling fan, but this is great because you don't have to hear your laptop take off for no reason. Even when I'm using Blender and DaVinci Resolve, it didn't get any warmer than room temperature. This is ideal laptop that you can actually place on your lap. I know it is much more expensive than previous M1 MacBook Air, but 2020 default M1 MacBook Air was an Apple's honest mistake to price them right. Thanks for watching. Until the next time I buy something fancy, I'll see you later. Bye.